In the last video, we looked at type 1 type improper integrals. In this video, we're going to do type 2. So type 1 improper integral looks kind of like this. We're interested in what is the total area of this region here. And we got that by cutting it off at a certain spot here, integrating from 0 to t, and then taking a limit as t went to infinity. We saw that there were some functions like e to the minus x and 1 over x squared and 1 over x to p for any value of p bigger than 1 where this integral would converge, that even though it's infinitely wide, you only have a finite amount of area. Now, a type 2 improper integral is figuring out what is the area of this region. Now, in other words, we're interested in a situation where the interval is perfectly reasonable, like maybe the integral here might be from negative 1 to 0, but the function blows up. The function has an infinite discontinuity at one end. So if the function blows up at 0, we're interested in the integral from negative 1 to 0 of f of x dx. And the way we get that is we say, you know what, we can't integrate all the way to 0. So we're going to integrate to a point really close to 0. We're going to go from negative 1 to t and get this area. And then we're going to push the barrier closer and closer and closer and closer to 0. So this integral is defined to be the limit as t approaches 0 from below of the integral from negative 1 to t of f of x dx. Now, does it have to be an integral where it's blowing up on the right-hand side? No. You could have a perfectly good improper integral where it's blowing up on the right-hand side. You could have something where the function blows up there, and you're interested in the integral from A to B, and it blows up at A. And again, our picture is we can't integrate all the way to A, but we can integrate all the way to a nearby point, T. And then we can take the limit as T approaches A. The integral from A to B of f of x dx is the limit as T approaches A of the integral from T to B of f of x dx. And T is always a little bit bigger than A in this situation, so we say T approaches A from above. Okay, so let's do an example. So our example is the integral from 0 to 1 of 1 over the square root of x. Now, as x approaches 0, 1 over the square root of x blows up because square root of x goes to 0 and 1 over a tiny number is huge. So we have to take a limit as t goes to 0 of the integral from t to 1. But computing the integral from t to 1 is easy. We know what an antiderivative of 1 over root x is. It's just twice root x. So we just have to do the take twice root x, plug it in at 1 and at t, and we get twice 1 minus root t. And now we say, what happens as t approaches 0? Well, if t is a tiny number, square root of t is a tiny number, 2 times 1 minus a tiny number is approximately 2. So the limit is 2. And just as with the other kind of improper integral, if the limit exists, we say it converges. And whatever the limit is, we say that's what it converges to. So the integral from 0 to 1 over 1 of root x dx converges to 2. Now, here's a warning. Here is a mistake that a lot of people make. If you see an integral like the integral from negative 1 to 1 of 1 over x squared dx, it's not blowing up at x equals 1, and it's not blowing up at x equals minus 1. So you might be tempted to do it as an ordinary integral. The antiderivative of 1 over x squared is minus 1 over x. You plug in 1 and minus 1, and you get negative 2. But you know that can't be right. Because if you draw a picture, this integral represents the area in this region. And that area is positive. There's no way the answer should be negative 2. So you cannot apply the fundamental theorem of calculus if the function is blowing up in the middle. Instead, if you've got a function that's blowing up at 0, you have to break it up into two pieces. Instead of writing the integral from negative 1 to 1, you have to write it as the integral from negative 1 to 0 plus the integral from 0 to 1. And you evaluate this integral and you evaluate this integral. You do them separately. And then if this converges to some number and this converges to some other number, then you add the two numbers together. And if either one of them diverges, too bad, you got infinitely much area, it doesn't work. So let's see what happens in this case. We'll do the first one first. We'll go instead of going from negative 1 to 0, we go from negative 1 to t and take a limit as t approaches 0. Well, now we can apply the fundamental theorem of calculus, negative 1 over x. We plug it in and we get this. And we say, what happens as t approaches 0? Well, if t is a tiny negative number, then minus 1 over t is going to be a gigantic positive number. This limit is infinity. It diverges. In this case, there's infinitely much area in this region. Likewise, you could work out that there's infinitely much area in this region. This integral diverges. This integral diverges. The whole thing diverges. Moral of the story, when you're faced with an integrand that blows up, whenever you have a place where the function you're integrating goes to infinity or minus infinity, you have to break the integral there and do an improper integral on the left and an improper integral